Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Duo here, and today I'll be bringing you the first episode of my newest reaction series, that being Netflix's Arcane, the show based off of League of Legends. Now, I'm going to preface this by saying I don't really know much about League, like from a lore standpoint. Heck, I don't even know most of the characters. I only really know the three that are the main characters of this, that being Jinx, Vi, and Caitlyn. But I tried playing League a while ago. I think it was before the show was even announced, and I'm not really a fan of MOBAs, so I never got into it. But this was the most voted show by my uni mates, to the point that it was unanimous, but so we're going to be giving this a shot. The first episode is titled Welcome to the Playground. Orphaned sisters Vi and Powder bring trouble to Zorn's underground streets in the wake of a heist in posh Piltover. Now, obviously, I'm going to be questionable with names just by reading it because, well, I've got no idea if what I'm saying is correct. But, yeah, I've got no idea for locations or anything. So, hopefully this is as good as people have said it is. And that I don't need to understand the lore to get the story, but yeah, we'll see. Let's get this started in 3, 2, 1, go. Play. I'm actually glad that did stuff up because I forgot about Netflix's whole, I'm going to error if you automatically play it. Also, is it Vi or V? I guess I'll find out, but I always thought it was V, but it's probably short for Violet, so I'll say it again. Little kids singing, always creepy. Yeah, that was the most logical with what I've heard from, well, what I've seen about this show. That it was a young Jinx singing. have no idea who this is. I know that there is something to do with, like, this is the thing with Noxus, isn't it? That being the, like, dark side of a rift or something. I've vaguely heard something like that. I don't know if that has any merit on this series, but I can only really speculate on the few fragments that I've got. Like, I'm assuming that was Vi and Jinx's family or community or whatever. I always like how things can have an ancient look and a future look as well. It is value, okay. I mean, that would be the whole steampunk aesthetic, but and she basically did it by herself. I mean, looks pretty picked. I almost said looks pretty kicked. I am glad that I managed to restrain myself until I had to explain it. That's a common trope, but I'd like to go out on a limb and guess that little man is one of those hamster creatures. Well, those look like power crystals. Okay, not a. That could still be a power crystal. Blame it on the inventor. Unless, of course, you get spotted. Really? They've got some self-expanding bolos. I love how they all have very distinct styles in how they're escaping. Like, normally they just put them all on, well, not the same loop, but similar loops, but. One thing I am really admiring is the animation of this. I mean, technically it was Vi that stuffed it up because she was the one who got spotted. If it wasn't for that, they could have just blamed it on the inventor. I mean, you've got an obvious brawler, a scrappy one, and a big guy. I don't really think you want to be going up against that. Even if the big guy's the only one who didn't get caught at least once. Oh, there we go. Street brawl, fight dirty. Oh. Can you really just make a nail bomb? in City of Embers right here. It took me way too long to remember the name of that. It lost the effect. That's fair. Yeah, that's a fair reaction. I mean, yeah, that's fair. You don't have anything, no evidence. Except, of course, there is evidence. A particular proclivity for pyrotechnics. But She's had dealings with them before. She knows how to talk with them. What's with the mask? Right. That makes sense. I mean, maybe if you got someone to actually teach you how to put them together better, instead of just shoving a handful of nails in and hoping that works. Check that in one of your kids' attractions. Respect one of yous, maybe. Fear the other. That was an interesting parallel. Because that looked like a shark. Especially with the water behind it. Is this some kind of mutagen? I may not be overly fond of sphinxes, but something better not happen to that cat. Something's going to happen to that cat. Rightio, well, I am thoroughly confused. So I'm assuming that's the antagonist. I know from, considering I'm watching this like a year and a half, 2 years after, I know that guy's name's Silco. But as for what his end goal is, I know he ends up with powder before or as she turns into Jinx. I know that. I had no idea who Vanda was. Don't know Echo, don't know Belson, or what was his name? I don't know if that enforcer that they gave a name to is like anyone significant. I don't know Clagger or Milo. I knew the Kuromans, obviously, because that's Caitlyn. But I also knew about the disparity between the High Town and the Low Town. Like, that, say, basis in any world like this. And yeah, it makes sense that Vi and, well, Powder are from the Lower Town. I don't know who the people at the start, excuse me, don't know who the people at the start were that killed their parents, because they didn't look like enforcers. They looked almost cybernetic or cyborg-like. And no, that there could be an enforcer. Lesser version of the mask that they were wearing in the underground. Hats sort of similar. Goggles could be to see through all the smoke and everything. That looks like the rifle that Caitlin uses in the game, so it could have been enforcers. I don't know Vader. I don't know what his deal is. He obviously had the gauntlets before Vi, or at least a prototype of them. Because you saw how he was wailing on the person on the bridge, and how they cracked the ground when he dropped them. But he also left them there. He shared a look with the... I'm just going to assume they were enforcers on the other side of the bridge as he walked off with the kids. That may have been when he made the agreement to keep his people out of Piltover. So, are they biological sisters? Or are they just adopted sisters? I'm assuming we'll find out later on, but I've always been confused about their relationship because I don't think in the game lore that they are related. And I know that they're at least adopted sisters in this, but considering when he gestured towards the dead parents, the one you could see clearly had Jinx's hair color. Yeah, I don't know. But this was an enjoyable show. I'll say again, the animation was really good. It's got its own unique style, which I wasn't sure how it's gonna feel about the look of the characters, if I'm being honest, because, well, it's very different from most modern cartoons, even adult cartoons, which this is, but, yeah, no, it worked with the, if anything, it enhances the animation style they used. But, anyway, I did like how they instantly subverted the whole, she only heard half of the statement, the bit that made it look bad, by turning around and be like, yeah, I said that, but also, these guys fuck up as well. We've all fucked up. Like, you're not a problem because of your mistakes. But anyway, very interested to see where this goes, like how it gets to what I know about this show, which is, of course, Jinx and Silco working together as Jinx has grown up. Like, how does that go together? I guess I'll have to watch and find out. I'll catch you in the next one.